Hello students, we continue further our discussion on aphorisms from 210 onwards. So in this presentation I'll be taking the aphorisms from 210 to 220. Aphorisms from 210 to 230 are discussing about the mental diseases and their treatment. So we start our discussion on mental diseases. So first aphorism is aphorism number 210. So what are mental diseases? They are one-sided diseases with too few symptoms. And here in mental diseases, the symptoms are predominantly of mind. Hence, they are called as mental diseases. So, what are mental diseases? So, the symptoms are predominantly of mind. They are termed as one-sided diseases and they are labeled as mental diseases. So, all one-sided diseases are psoriatic. We already saw one-sided diseases are chronic in nature and miasmatic in origin. So diseases with condition of disposition of mind, which is altered, are mental diseases. They are not a separate class at all. So, mental diseases is nothing separate but a disease where the predominantly mental symptoms are present and disposition of mind is altered. In all diseases, mind symptoms are altered. Disposition changes in all these illnesses. Disposition is different before illness and after illness. So what is disposition of mind? It is nothing but person's inherent qualities of mind and character. So these are inherent qualities of a person, of that person. His mood or general attitude towards life. Positive or negative way a person views the world. So basically disposition is the inherent qualities of mind. So we are going to discuss one-sided diseases called as mental diseases where symptoms predominantly of mind are present. Here, the disposition of mind is altered and all the changes in the disposition are reflected as symptoms and that is the illness of the patient. And in today's terms of psychiatry, we are knowing the diseases which are called as paranoid disorders, which are called as schizophrenia, which are psychotic traits. All such diseases are coming under the title of mental diseases. So we go further. Here we want to just keep it in mind the most important symptom, the disposition, which is before the illness and after the illness, or what is the changed disposition of the patient. So the disposition of mind which is reflecting as symptoms is the most important. So disposition of mind of patient will determine the selection of the remedy. Symptoms of mind are the characteristic symptoms. These cannot remain concealed from the accurately observing physician, and these symptoms are important. So the most important symptoms of mind they determine the selection of the remedy. And these, if characteristic symptoms, then the choice of simulimum is easy. So symptoms of mind, they are characteristic symptoms if they are having the emotions which are the cause of this mental illness. So causative modality of emotional symptoms such as ailments from grief, ailments from anger, ailments from insult, ailments from fright, all these will form the mental diseases. So the mental symptoms, especially of emotional type, are the most important characteristic symptoms. Out of those, the causative emotional modality, then the aggravating emotional modality, and then the ameliorating emotional modality are the most important symptoms, and they will point out the selection of remedy. These symptoms cannot remain concealed from the accurately observing physician. All these symptoms are important. Patient will narrate these symptoms, and also the history will be given by patient's relatives and friends. Symptoms such as delusions, fixed ideas are the most important symptoms guide to the selection of the remedy. These symptoms will often be given by patient himself. So disposition of mind in today's times is very important. So as we have seen, disposition of mind is nothing but patient's inherent qualities of the mind. So we were, as a physician, he should be aware of the symptoms of mind before illness as well as after illness. And of course, what symptoms are present today at this time, they are most characteristic symptoms. So we go further. Aphorism number 212. The creator of therapeutic agent means what? The meaning is the Almighty. So the medicines affect the mind, and every powerful medicinal substance in the world alters the state of mind and disposition. So the creator has produced all the medicinal substances in the world, and they alter the state of mind and disposition. And we observe this in healthy poor. Now, this is with reference to these medicines which are able to produce the certain set of symptoms will only be acting as curative. So, we should look for the medicines which affect the mind. So every powerful medicinal substance in the world alters the state of mind and disposition. And this is noted in the symptoms given by healthy prover. So we are having the knowledge of medicines, that what these medicines will produce the symptoms. And of course, the job of homeopath, now you are well aware that these medicines which are producing the certain set of symptoms at the level of mind will then be acting as curative. So the disease producing power is the disease curing power, and it is not only true in the physical symptoms, but it is very well applicable in the mental symptoms also. So we go further. Aphorism number 213. So homeopathic cure, which is a natural science, because as we have seen in the previous aphorisms, say aphorism number 26, right, the starting aphorisms, that the law of cure, therapeutic law of cure. Here we already saw that in nature, the stronger disease, for example, our usual example, smallpox cures ophthalmia. So the cure takes place in nature, that stronger similar disease extinguishes weaker similar disease. So in homeopathy also, the stronger similar disease produced by the similimum extinguishes the weaker natural disease. So homeopathic cure is not possible if we do not observe the disposition of mind of patient. So homeopath has to give the most important attention to the disposition of mind of patient. So always in a given case, the homeopath has to find out the disposition of mind of patient. So homeopathic cure, which is a natural science, homeopathy is a natural science, because it is based on the therapeutic law of nature. So we already saw this example, that smallpox removes ophthalmia owing to the similarity. Thus, any medicine which produces the same set of symptoms which are now seen in the patient will be acting as curative. Even in acute diseases, observe the symptoms of mind along with the other symptoms. So we have in aconite, where the patient is having fever and he is so restless mentally, he predicts the time of death. This is nothing but the symptom of mind in acute disease, and this calls for the prescription of aconite. Even in the fever cases, if the patient, young girl in the having fever, complains of continuous weeping, symptom told by the mother will call for the prescription of Pulsatilla. So the in acute diseases, if the symptoms of mind predominate, it calls for the prescription, where the most important symptom is of mind along with the symptom of body. Select the remedy such that it has produced the symptoms as in its pathogenesis. I already told you the disease curing power lies in the disease producing power. So select the remedy that it has produced the symptoms in its pathogenesis, and at the both the planes, at the plane of mind, at the plane of body. So aconite does not cure calm and quiet patient. Nux vomica does not soothe to mild patient, and Pulsatilla does not soothe to happy and gay patient. So aconite will be suiting to the patient who is mentally restless and who predicts the time of death. Nux vomica patient will always be irritable, whereas Pulsatilla patient will be weepy. So these remedies will act curative if such symptoms are found in patient. So we go to the next aphorism number 214. Mental diseases are cured in the same as all other diseases. Cure of mental diseases is possible only when the remedy is capable of producing in body and mind the symptoms similar to the symptoms present in the case of disease. There is no other remedy which can cure but only this remedy, which is capable of producing both symptoms of body and mind. And these symptoms, if observed in Prover, are listed in homeopathic materia medica. Then these symptoms are matched with the symptoms of patient. So there is no other remedy which can cure but only this. So the remedy, it is capable of producing the set of symptoms in the Prover, will be acting curatively if similar set of symptoms found in the patient. So the cure of mental disease is possible only when remedy is capable of producing in body and mind the symptoms similar to the symptoms present in the case of a disease. So we go to the next aphorism number 215. We see the first variety discussed by Dr. Hahnemann, that is mental symptoms arise with decline of corporeal symptoms. So this is the first variety. The mental or emotional diseases like corporeal, bodily and physical diseases. So mental symptoms arise with decline of corporeal symptoms. Here physical symptoms are becoming very small. They appear one-sided diseases like a local disease in visible subtle organ of mind. So it appears as a local disease but of mind. So predominantly mental symptoms are present in this type of variety of mental symptoms.